when Cinderella came around and we were in part of the decade in the 80s where so much importance was placed on the visual because of MTV, I think the over-the-top look that developed in the 80s was a result of us wanting to take our heroes to a whole nother fucking level. And the 80s was all about excess. And, you know, and I think that it was, that's what it was about, you know, and I think that, you know, probably most of my buddies from those bands, you know, would tell you the same thing, you know, it came from that glam, hard rock, you know, imagery of the 60s and the 70s and trying to take it somewhere new, because now all of a sudden there was this, this new visual thing called MTV, where it was as much about the visual as it was about the music. So, you know, I think that the whole decade got caught up in that, and not just in the rock scene, but I mean, you look at the pop scene from Cyndi Lauper to Boy George to Madonna to, you know, everything in the 80s was fucking over the top. And it was cool. It was a great decade. You know, it was a lot of fun. Mark Weitz, one of my very best buddies, he shot the cover for Night Songs for us. And it was shot in the historic district of Philadelphia, which is where we were from. The most interesting thing that I remember about that shoot was the album was called Night Songs, and Mark scheduled the shoot for daytime. And I kept saying to him, that's not gonna look right. And he said, I shoot day for night. And I don't know what the fuck that meant. And I just trusted him, because I kind of liked this guy right off the bat. I thought he was a straight up cat. And sure enough, when we got the pictures back, it looked like it was nighttime. So Mark Weitz is a fucking genius. Ha ha ha.